So on public demand, we are going to create this awesome manga clone animation inside the free version of DaVinci Resolve. And I'll also be sharing project files in a community post, but it will be available for the channel members only. So if you are interested, you can get it just in 29 rupees. Alright, let's get started. Okay, so here I am on the edit page of DaVinci Resolve, and as you can see, I have already added this background clip along with this manga clip of Gojo, which I got from YouTube by the way. And also, I have added these three markers. So before you follow me, make sure to add everything properly. Alright, now the first thing we are going to do is slow down this clip little bit, because I want to stretch it up to here. Okay, so let's do this. Right click on this clip and from the menu look for change clip speed. Okay, simply click here, and here you will see the speed option. Double click on it and let's change it to something like 70 and click on this change button. Now you can simply click here and drag it, and you see it's filling properly. Now what we are going to do is make two copies of this clip. So simply press alt and left click and drag, and it will make a copy. Now let me slim down the timeline a little bit. I'll simply press shift and scroll down, and it will sync the timeline. And then I will make another copy by pressing alt and dragging a little. Okay, so now what we are going to do is simply click on this first clip and click here, then trim it down until the first marker. Okay, then click on the second clip and trim it down until it reaches the second marker. Okay, now simply select all this clip, right click on it and create a new fusion page. Click here and we are done. Now simply open the fusion page and you'll have something like this. Now the first thing first, I'm going to rearrange all these nodes properly because I don't like how DaVinci Resolve does it by default, but if you want, you can keep it as it is. Okay, so I'll simply click on this background node and push it somewhere here. Then I will move this median one node around here, then take these two notes and arrange them properly. Okay, let me fast forward all this so you don't get bored. Okay, now what we are going to do is rename all these merge nodes so that we don't get confused later on. Click on this first merge node, then press 1 on your keyboard to view it on the left viewer. Now if you press F2, it will open this rename tool and simply rename it as BG because this is our background. Okay, now simply click on this merge 2 node, then press 1. Now you see nothing is visible because we have to move a little bit forward in order to see it. So this is our first clone. So press F2 and rename it as clone 1. Okay. And then click on this merge 3 node. Press F2 and rename it as clone 2. And now simply click on this merge 4 node and I will simply rename it as main. Okay. Now simply click on this clone 1 node. Then press 1 to remove it from the left viewer. Then go to this top right section and here you will see this icon. Simply click here to switch to single view mode. Alright, now let's do the animation, and for that we need to see the markers because you see by default it's not visible and there's a reason why we added them. So to view it, you can simply click on this keyframe icon to open it. Then simply click on this zoom to fit icon and it will reveal all the markers. Okay, now let's focus on the animation. So I will simply click on this media in node of this clone one, then drag it upwards like this and add a transform node to it. Now if you want, you can also animate this clone one instead of adding a transform node, but that might mess up your visuals once you add the glow. So we are going to avoid it, okay? Now first thing first, go to this first marker, then simply go to inspector and add a keyframe for center XY, then also add a keyframe for angle. Now simply move the second marker, then go to the inspector, then click and drag this X box until it reveals your secondary. Let's see. So I am going to keep it somewhere around here. And also simply double click on this angle box, then change the value to 10. Now simply click here to apply the changes. Now if you notice, we have to fix this area at the bottom. Let me simply move the viewer a little bit. Then I will simply click on this Y box and drag it down until it fits properly. Okay, now let's reveal the second clone. So I will simply click on this media end node and drag it upwards like this. And also add a transform node to it. Then go to the inspector and add a keyframe for center XY and also for the angle. Now simply move your playhead to this last marker, go to the inspector and click on this edge box and drag it to the right side. Let's see. I guess I am going to keep it somewhere around here. Now simply double click on this angle box and change the value to -5. Click here to apply the changes and we'll have something like this. So we need to adjust the Y as well. So click here and drag it down until it fits properly. Let's see. Let me move the viewer a little bit and adjust it properly. So somewhere around here looks good. Now let's close this tab. Go to frame 0, double click here and play it. So we'll have something like this. Now of course it's not looking good because it's too slow. So we have to adjust the cuts. So let's do this. Simply go to this top right section and it will have this spline icon. Click here and it will open the tab. Now what we are going to do is simply select this transform 1 and transform 2. Then click on this zoom to fit icon to see all the keyframes. If you want, you can select them like this or you can press Ctrl plus A to select all the keyframes. Now simply right click on this graph and here you will see this ease option. And from here, choose the out key leak. Simply close this spline tab, go to frame 0, double click here and play it. So we'll have something like this and now it's looking much better than before. Alright, now let's move on. Okay, let me adjust the viewer a little bit. So somewhere around here, okay. Okay, now let's convert the clones into neon outline. For that, simply click on this transform node. Now press Ctrl plus space and search for edge detect, EDGE edge detect. So this one, press enter to add it. And once you add, you'll have something like this. Now first thing first, we're going to select all these nodes and drag it somewhere around here to rearrange them. And now click here once to deselect everything. And then select this edge detect node, go to the inspector, and here you will see this mode option. Simply click here and change it to grayscale, and it will reveal the colors tab. By clicking on this mini arrow, you can expand it, and if you go to this right side, you will see this slider. Click and drag it to change the color. I am going to keep it somewhere bluish. Now to apply the color, you just have to click here and drag it. Let's see, I am going to keep it somewhere around here to make it a little bit brighter. Okay, now let's add a glow to it. So press Ctrl plus trace and search for soft glow. S-O-F-T, soft glow. Press enter to add it. Alright, let's rearrange the nodes properly. Simply move it upwards like this. Click here once to deselect everything. Then select the soft glow node. Go to the inspector. And first thing first, we are going to decrease the gain a little bit, somewhere around here. And also, let's increase the glow size, somewhere around 50 would look good enough. If you want to use a few different colors on your neon outline, you can do this by adding a color corrector node. So for that, you just have to click on this edge detect node and add a CC node to it. Simply click here to add it. Now let's rearrange it, somewhere around here. Deselect everything, click on this color corrector node, go to the inspector and move this color wheel to change the color. Now in order to apply this color in different sections, we just have to add mask. So I will simply click on this ellipse mask to add it and move it somewhere around here. And also I will decrease its size, let's see. Okay, now simply go to inspector and click on this invert icon to invert it and increase the soft glow to match this properly. Now we are going to apply all these nodes on our second clone as well. Okay, so this is how it's looking. I guess I am going to change the color of our background a little bit, and also I am going to add a little bit color on our main tree. So let's do this. Simply click on this median on node, drag it upwards like this and add a color corrector node to it. Go to inspector and simply move the color wheel to change the color. So I am going to match it with the neon glow, so I will keep it somewhere around here. Okay, so it's matching properly. And also we are going to add a little bit reddish tone as well. So what I am going to do, I will simply click on this color corrector node, press Ctrl plus C to copy it, then click on this node, press Ctrl plus V to paste it. Let's rearrange the nodes properly. Okay, so now click here once to deselect everything, select this color corrector node and add a ellipse mask to it. Now let's adjust this mask. So simply click here and move it somewhere around here. Now what we are going to do is invert this mask and simply increase the soft edge a little bit, let's see. And also I am going to increase border width. So okay, so now it's looking good. Okay, now simply double click here and we'll have something like this. Okay, now let's change the color of our main click. But first thing first, I am going to move this ellipse mask somewhere around here and then click on this median node and drag it upwards like this. Then select this color corrector node, press Ctrl plus C to copy it and click on this median node, press Ctrl plus V to paste. Now go to inspector and decrease the saturation a little bit. And also scroll down and increase the brightness. Now if you see, it's affecting the whole clip, we don't want it, so we'll simply scroll upwards and go to this option tab. And here you will see this pre-divide and post-multiply. Simply select this box and it will apply on our main clip only. Now you can simply go back to color tab and do the necessary adjustments. The rest of the process is actually same, so I'm going to skip it, okay? Alright, so here I have already color corrected the main cloth as well. Now let me show you how you can achieve the aura effect. It's actually quite easy and I already have a dedicated tutorial on that. So if you want, you can check it out because I'm not going to show everything in details. Now first thing first, let me adjust the node area a little bit. So I will simply middle click here and drag it around this place. Then we are going to click on this median node and move it upwards like this. Now simply press Ctrl plus C to copy it. Then press Ctrl plus B to paste the node once again. Okay. Now let's adjust it. So click on this copied node and drag it somewhere around here. Then click on this merge node and move it around this place. Now what we're going to do is add a displace node in order to create the aura. So click on this median node, then press Ctrl plus space, and if you type DSP, it will reveal the displace node. Press enter to add it. Now we are also going to add a fastness node in order to create the effect. So go to this left side and here you will see this fastness node. Click here and drag it somewhere around here. Take its output and connect it with the displace node. Now simply go to inspector, then here you will see the scale option. Click here and drag it all the way up. And also simply drag the C-thread slider and drag it all the way up as well. Now simply click on this displace node, go to inspector and you will see this refraction strength option. So click on this slider and move it slightly, so around here. Okay, now if you notice, the aura is appearing on top of our main clip. We don't want it, we want it behind. So for that, we'll simply click on this merge node, then go to inspector and on this operator tab, simply click here and go to bottom, click on this under option. Now you can simply click on this displace node, go to inspector and do the necessary adjustments. So what I'm going to do is simply decrease the offset a little bit. Let's see. So I guess I'm going to keep it somewhere around here and also increase the refraction strength a little bit more. Around here looks good, and I guess I'm going to change the center XY as well. So I will click on this Y box and move it upwards. Let's see, somewhere around here. And also I'm going to play with this X offset as well. Let's see. Okay, so now it's looking good. Now it's actually totally up to you, so you have to adjust it according to your taste. And also I'm going to add a little bit glow to it. So press Ctrl plus space and search for soft glow, soft soft, press enter to add it. And now let's adjust it. So I'll simply click on this gain and move it left side to decrease it. Around 0.4 looks good, and also increase the glow size a little bit. Let's see, so somewhere around 0.5 looks good enough. Okay, now let me show you how you can copy this aura effect on your clones as well. So for that, simply select this fast noise and displace node, press Ctrl plus C to copy it, then click here and press Ctrl plus V to paste it. And we just have to repeat the same process. But before you do that, let me simply click here and drag it a little bit here. And what I'm going to do is simply select all these nodes of our main clip. So let me select it until the color parameter node. Then press Ctrl plus G to make a group. Now let me adjust them a little bit. Alright, now let's create the aura for our clones. So first thing first, click on this media and 3 node, press Ctrl plus C to copy it, then press Ctrl plus V to paste it. Now let me adjust it properly around here and also here. And what we're going to do is simply select this displace node, press shift and drag it around here. Now simply drag this fast noise node to around this place and connect it with the displace node. And as you can see, it has created the aura. So click on this merge node, go to inspector, and in this operator, click here, go to this under and click on it. Okay, so this is how it's looking. Now you can simply adjust the values according to your taste and repeat the same process for our another clone as well. Alright, so as you can see, I have already created aura for my second clone as well. Now let's add motion blur, then we are going to preview it. We need to add motion blur on our clones only. So for that, we'll simply select these two group nodes and move them upwards. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is simply click on this group 3 node, press Ctrl plus space, and I will search for optical flow, OPTICAL, optical. We are going to add this, so press enter to add it. Then press Ctrl plus space once again and search for vector motion blur, VECTOR vector. So we are going to add this second one, press enter to add it. Okay, now let me rearrange it. So I will simply move it here. Then what we are going to do is move this group a little bit upwards. We'll select this optical flow node, press Ctrl plus C to copy it, and we're going to click here and paste it, and we'll do the same for this one. Select it, copy, click on this one, and then press Ctrl plus V to paste it. Okay, now we can preview it. So let's go to edit page and let's preview it. So we'll have something like this, and as you can see, it's looking quite good. Now keep that in mind, the optical flow and vector motion blur is actually pretty heavy, so it might take a little bit time to render. Okay. Now what you are going to do is simply stop it, then simply go to this deliver page, go to left side and simply click on this, move it somewhere around here until you see this YouTube option. Click on it, then change the file name, and from here you can choose your location. I already have set it. So what I'm going to do is simply click on this render, then we are going to click here to render it out. Alright, so my render is done and I have also imported the clip. So now what we're going to do is simply select this fusion clip and press backspace to delete it. Then go to media pool, right click here and create a new fusion composition. Press enter to create it. Simply click on this fusion composition and drag it to the timeline and place it in the beginning. Now I will simply go here, press Ctrl plus B, then I will select this right side and press backspace to delete it. Now the next thing we're going to do is change the resolution. So click on this project settings icon. And from here, tick this vertical resolution box and press save, and it will apply the resolution. Now place the playback head on top of it and open it in Fusion Page. Okay, now simply click on this media out node and drag it somewhere around here. Then go to this left side and click and drag this background node to the workspace. Okay, take its output and connect it with the media out node. Simply go to media pool and drag our clip. Click here and drag it to the workspace. Take its output and connect it with the output of our background node. Now let's adjust it. So go to inspector and just increase its size until it fits properly. Let's see. So I guess around 1.8 looks good enough. And for that, we're going to add another transform node. So simply click here to add it. Then go to frame 0. Simply go to this top right section and click on this keyframes icon to open it. Now let's click on this zoom to fit icon to view the markers. Now simply go to inspector and add a keyframe for center XY size and also for the angle. Now let's move to first marker, which is frame 15, I guess. And at this point, I'll simply add another keyframes for each of them. So let's add keyframe for each of them. Then go back to pen 0, go to inspector, and simply increase the size a little bit. Let's see, somewhere around 1.6, I guess. And also, I'm going to change the angle to, let's see, something around, I guess, minus 5 looks good. Now what we're going to do is simply move to the second marker, which is on frame 30 for me. Simply go to inspector and drag the ins value until it reveals the first clone. So let's see, I'll move it somewhere around here. And first thing first, I'm going to change the angle. So I'll simply drag it upwards, let's see. And let's keep it somewhere around 6. And also, I'm going to increase the size a little bit. So I'm going to keep it somewhere around 1.2. And also, let's adjust the X and Y. We need to adjust the Y a little bit as well. So somewhere around here. Okay, now let's move to this third marker, which is our last marker, by the way. And at this point, simply drag this X value until it reveals the second clone. So we're around here. And first thing first, change the angle. So I'm going to keep it minus 5. And let me adjust the size a little bit more. 1.3. Okay. So at this point, I'll simply drag this X around here. Okay. So now it's looking good. Now simply move to last frame of your composition. And at this point, change the values back to normal. So double click here, change it to 0.5. Double click on this box as well and change it to 0.5. And also click on the size box, change it to 1. And then double click on this angle box, change it to 0. Now simply click here to apply the changes. Now before you play it, simply close this keyframes tab and open the spline tab. Simply select this transform box to select everything and click here once. And then press Ctrl plus A to select all the keyframes. Right click and on this ease section, choose the out cubic option. Okay, now let's close it. Then go to edit page. And let's play it. So we'll have something like this, and it's looking pretty cool. And that's how you create a neon manga clone animation inside the pre version of DaVinci Resolve. And if the tutorial was helpful, then give it a like and also subscribe to the channel. Make sure to check out my other videos, and I will see you in the next video. So see ya.